realize that it hasn't been all that many years, or certainly my lifetime, that the only forensic evidence that we had, and that was even pretty sketchy at that, was blood type. You know, AB or AB or O, one of four blood types. And you hope that your murderer had the rare AB. And that's just about, that was about all the science we had. Unless you're talking about pistols. You know, they couldn't match, of course. They could just say, well, it was a 45, and, you know, that was it. And going back even further, say the days of the Wild West, you know, they were tried and hung on the same day, you know. I don't know what it was like back east, but, you know, the eyewitness testimony was king. But anyway, now we have, yes, I did see that February disclosure of that. It was a rather odd report. I've got it here in front of me. The judge had called for everybody's DNA, you know, all of the Anthony's DNA. And he had stated, all right, we need to get, you know, some of this cleared up. And so he had ordered the DNA test, the paternity, see if they could get to the bottom of the paternity question. And so I was kind of, I noticed this odd little sentence at the end of a report that included checking a car seat and a steering wheel cover, debris from a spare tire, wheel well, a swab from the tire wheel well, checking them for evidence of any DNA. Well, then at the very end of the report, oh, it talks about, you know, that they tested with nuclear DNA. You know, actually talking about DNA with me is something like getting a root canal. It's really not my favorite evidence, but it is conclusive, without a doubt. But nevertheless, it's like they're speaking Swahili. Anyway, in the second page of this report, it says they tested Lee Anthony and George and Cindy, and they found out for a sex identification that George was a male and Lee was a male and Cindy was a female, which I think that's really, really helpful. So, and they, what do they call that test? Oh, I'm not going to try it. Deoxybronchonucleic, no, that's DNA. PCR to test for gender. And there was no DNA on any of those other specimens that were in the car that were mentioned. You know, the tire well and debris, you know. But in a little sentence at the very end of this report on checking for DNA on the car contents, is this one line, based on the STR typing results, the DNA obtained from specimen Q18-1, that is Caylee, could not have originated from a biological offspring of the individual represented by specimen K9, Lee Anthony. Okay. Because no STR typing results were obtained, the tested specimens are not eligible of the, you know, car contents. No other serological or nuclear DNA examinations were conducted. Well, just about everything I know about DNA is mitochondrial DNA can trace the female line, but you need nuclear DNA in order to track the paternity or the male line. And it apparently this STR typing results, I looked it up, but it isn't something that I am competent to explain. Apparently it is a preliminary, an early test that is, rather than proving anything, it can exclude. So it's exclusionary. And so they tested to see if Lee and George were males using this DNA, and it also tested Lee and found that he could not be the father, and at least that's the way I interpret this. Now, the question that I have, it says they went to all the trouble of working up George's DNA. Why didn't they just simply add one more sentence and say, why didn't the report state that Caylee could not have originated from either Lee or George? Why didn't it? Why is George still in the running? I mean, that's the way I take it. And I, as I tell you, it looks more like Swahili to me. Of course, I have said from the very beginning that the photos, the pictures of George and Caylee were compelling to me. And I go by a triangle. I use a triangle. I don't know if I ever even attempted to explain it, but you can ID a person pretty much just on their eyes and the triangle made by their eyes and nose. But anyway, that's about it. Lee is eliminated. George is still in the running. We have a very highly secretive family on this topic. I rule out the possibility of a married man, unless it's someone very, very close to you. Nothing seems to really hold up very well in that, somebody going off to Iraq, or she would have, and the pressure that was put on Jesse Grund to get married that she insisted that he was the father, even though it didn't work out on the calendar at all. This seems to point to something else, doesn't it? Well, anyway, for that, I wanted to just correct that and take a look on the links on the right-hand side that says more info, and you'll be able to examine these reports yourself. Until then.